Hello, Dissenters! My name is Etalyx, and I am here today playing a little bit of Tribes Ascend on the PC. This is not an Is It Worth It or anything like that. It's just a gameplay, and it's a commentary because I felt it was a good thing to do considering that Tribes Ascend has officially released on PC today. That's April 12th for those of you watching from the future. Like I said, this is a PC exclusive title, and it is a very fast-paced shooter. It's also free to play, so for anyone who is interested in this game, you are just free at your own leisure to download this game, try it out for yourself, make sure it runs on your computer, see if you have fun playing it. Now, you obviously, with free-to-play games, you have some restrictions, and those restrictions are your weapons and armor and things like that. Now, what I mean is, you know, you're gonna get the basics. There's 9 classes in total. You're gonna start with 3, and there's gonna be various unlocks with all of those classes. You can buy unlocks with either XP that you earn by playing, or by buying their tribe's gold, which is going to cost you real-world money. Now, what exactly am I watching on screen, you might be asking? I am playing as the Raider class with the Arx Buster. I'm currently playing Capture the Flag and my team's generator room, trying to defend that generator room and repair my team's generator. For those of you unfamiliar with this game, why might that be significant, you might be asking? Each team has a generator in Capture the Flag, and the reason that you want to keep it safe and keep it up to speed, repaired, and all that good stuff is because that is what's going to power your team's turrets, your team's radar, things like that. Your team's technician classes will have turrets that they can place down. Personal turrets, it will disable those if the generator is not working, so you want to make sure to defend it or attack the enemy's generator and disable their turrets, because those are strategically placed around each base's flag point so that, you know, it can defend it a little better. So by disabling an enemy generator, you're helping your team get to the flag easier, and by keeping it repaired, you're helping keep the enemy at bay from your own flag. So that's kind of what I'm doing here. Any class can pick up a repair unit from the little plus medical sign looking symbols just by pressing G and just repair it yourself. Now, this is not as effective as actually being a technician class and repairing it, but still trying to get some points. I apologize, guys, for the slowdown that will occasionally hit the video. I'm attempting to record with a new capture software, so very rarely you're gonna see it sputter. That's not your own computer. It's my own fault, still trying to get the kinks worked out of this system, but don't worry, it only happens once or twice. Just, I don't want you to panic. I'm trying DX Tori now. I'm moving away from Fraps, and is that a tank? A tank just came down here into the generator room. What is going on? I have never seen that before. I've played this game, I haven't played it extensively, but I've played it enough to know that that is really bizarre. This almost dead tank just rolled down there while I was defending the generator, repairing it, and luckily, he was just almost dead enough for me to finish him off. It was just really crazy. I was like, it's a tank! What is going on here? Now, there's a lot of roles you can play. I was playing defend the generator room for a minute there, trying to repair it for my team, which I successfully did, and I believe they may have destroyed it again after I left. You can also go capture the flag. This is the classic game type. Some of you may not like this game type, which is fine. There are other game types available in Tribes, including Team Deathmatch and 2 other game types, one of which I know you have to level up for. And I believe that is the arena game type, which is a smaller match between fewer amounts of people. You have to be like level 8 in order to play that, or at least you did during the open beta. Now, I've been playing this game since closed beta, so I just wanted to come back and say hello to Tribes now that it has officially released, and just see what I could do and just show you guys the game to encourage you to go play it for yourself, because it is a lot of fun. And it's definitely, it's not one of a kind just because it's influenced by the games of old, the Tribes of old, but currently, in the modern day shooters, this is one of a kind. So I definitely encourage you guys to go check it out because it is a lot of fun. I don't know if I'm going to do Is It Worth It style videos on free-to-play games. I'm not going to say I won't, because it's very likely that I will at some point. There's no reason not to. What do you guys think about that? Let me know in the comments below. I guess it doesn't matter. I mean, it could just be a review of a game, even if it's for free. The Is It Worth It is not just about how much you're paying for it, but also about if it's worth your time and energy and things like that. But that's a conversation for another video. But you feel free to leave me your comments, your thoughts in the comments below. Now, what I'm doing here is kind of defending my own flag. Actually, I think I'm about to get killed by a tactical strike here in a second. There's a little infiltrator. You might have seen him glistening in the sun down there. There is an infiltrator class that can go invisible, and he was throwing some mines up here, some grenades. So I found him. Whenever you attack whilst invisible, you will become visible briefly. And I managed to find him, and our team took him down. And like I said, defending the flag here, but there are tactical strikes that you can use. Yes, in there, I finally exploded. At the top right of my screen, you'll notice that I have credits, which I can earn by getting kills, getting assists, getting flag captures and returns, repairing the generator, and I just happened to get a nice lucky kill after spawning on that flag carrier, defending the flag for my team. But with those credits at the top right, you can actually call in tactical strikes or supply drops. You'll notice me picking up those little floating canisters on the ground. Those drop whenever an enemy dies. Or actually, I think whenever a friendly dies too, so you can just pick it up and it'll help refill your ammo. You'll notice I do have a limited amount of ammo on my gun. You can see it on the counter. Whenever I run out, the way you can refill that is by going back to a station at your own home base, or by picking up the canisters from the fallen foes or your fallen enemies. But where the credits come into play is, like I said, you do have supply drops. So you can spend credits, call in a supply drop, and refill your ammo anywhere on the fly. There are a ton of good things about tribes that I simply do not have the time to talk about during this video. I just wanted to show you guys the game again. It's been a long time since I did a video. I know I've featured it in my live streams from time to time. But like I said, it's been a while since I had an actual video on it. So definitely go check out Tribes Ascend. It is free to play and it has just released today. If you have any questions about this game, if I can answer them, I will do my best. Feel free to ask below. If you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate it if you left me a rating and some thoughts. And I hope to see you again. My name is Etalyx and I will see you next time.